Let us continue with our lesson, and today we'll be learning about the Kotlin data class. So the purpose of the data class is to handle a data or to hold a data, and it's very easy in Kotlin to create our data class and where we can hold a data very easily. Likewise, if you have programmed in a Java before, and when we had to create some kind of a model, let's say we need to create a model for our user, or we had to create a model for our any of the classes like our model class. At that time, we had to write all of the properties, and we had to write properties getters, setters, and also we need to write a lot of like a toString, and we have to override some of the methods over there. But with the help of the Kotlin, it's really simple, and we can just create our data class with of one single line of code. So let's go and see in a practical way. So let's jump into our project over here, and I will create a new class. So let's go and we'll create a new class over here, and I will call it as a, let's say, student and student data, and I'll just click on OK. So we have a student data. To convert this one to a data class, we just have to make use of our data keyword over here, and that's, sorry, I need to put it over here. So data class, and we have a data class of student data, and there is a certain thing that we need to take care of whenever we are creating a data class. The first thing is that it must have a constructor. And the constructor should, the primary constructor should have at least one parameter. So there need to be at least one parameter. So data class must have at least one primary constructor parameter. So we need to create a one parameter, and let's say a var of our name, and also let's create a var of a last name, and also of a var of a age. So we have a three parameter over here. Sorry, this should be var, and we have created a var, and we also need to assign our data type. Sorry for that one. It should be of a string, and this should be also of a string, and this should be of a int. Sorry, it should be int, and let's provide a bit space over here for okay, so code readability. And so we have a three parameter over here, and we have created a data class. So that's it. So just with the help of a single line of code, we already have created a data class, and it has implemented all of the functionality, like function like get to string. And it also has a copy equals hash code that we need to manually have to override in our Java class whenever we were writing a model class. But in Kotlin, it's really easy and simple. All of the things will be generated by a compiler, like toString method will be implemented by a compiler itself. We don't have to write getter, setter, anything. It's just a simple data class with just one line of code. That's the power of a Kotlin. And another thing that we have to take note is whenever we create a variable over here, the parameter, so if you remove a var keyword over here, then it will give us errors. So whenever we create a parameter over here in our data class, make sure we have a var or a val. So these two keywords must be used whenever we are creating a parameter variable over here. And if you never pass that one, if you never say that a var or a val over here with a parameter, then this will give us an error. And another thing is that this class cannot be of open, or you cannot make use of an open keyword over here, or if you want, you cannot make use of a abstract, let's say ABS abstract over here. So that's not allowed over here. So data is a purely data class. We cannot have anything mentioned like open, or you cannot mention it as abstract, inner, or a sealed class. And another thing is that it can also implement, like it can also extend or implement the interface or the other classes. Like let's say we already have an interface of a remote, and if you want to implement, let's go back to our student data over here. And if you want to implement that one, we can just say as a remote, and we can implement that one, and we can implement all of the, we can override the method over here. Sorry for that one. And we can implement the constructor, implement the member. Just call. Okay. So we have successfully implemented our interface in our data class. But let's remove this one. We don't have to implement for now. We are not going to use it for now. So let's just have a simple data class with of a three parameter over here. And let's go and make use of this data class. So how do we make use of this data class and assign a value for it? And let's go to the our activity over here, fraud activity. And let me comment all of this because I will not using it out. And let's go over here and I will just say as a var keyword of let's say a data, and sorry, it should be std data, let's say is equals to, we have a std and the student data, and in the constructor we need to pass a three argument over here, which is of a name, last name and an age. So the name, let's pass it as a demo name, and let's pass the last name as a demo last name. Hey, sorry for that one. This should be of our demo last name. And finally we have a age, so it's, let's pass as a 25. So now we have passed the parameter over here, and if you want to log the d, let's log it as a d and tag over here. And if we can, we can just get the data from here, and so let me create a template over here, and we can say as a name each of let's access that data over here as a std data dot, and we can get a name, and similarly let's get a last name. And it should be of just copy this one and just paste it over here, and let's paste it over here. So here I'll get a age, and here I'll get a last name, and here let's say it's a age. Okay, so we have logged, and let us run this application. And what we need to do is we need to filter it out by this tag. Just copy and let's go to the logcat for now and just clear it out everything. And just paste this abstract over here. And let us wait for the Gradle well to finish up. So here now you can see that we have successfully logged all of our argument or parameter, and we have passed the parameter over here, and we have get access to that value. So we are accessing the value, and it might not be quite useful for now because we haven't dealt with any kind of data. But when we are actually dealing with some kind of data, let's say you want to get a data from the API, from a web server, or you want to get a data from your database, at that time this kind of or this data class is very, very useful. So we don't have to write a getter and setter like in our Java class, and it's really simple in a Kotlin to make use of a data class. It might not be quite useful for now, and you may be wondering that there's no use of for all of this, but when later in stage when you want to go and create an actual app and you want to get some data from your REST API or from your database, at that time it will be really useful. So that's all for this lesson. We'll continue with our lesson on next video. Till then, have a great day.